Hello everyone, welcome to the session on cybersecurity. So we have already started module 6, now we are going to continue that. Today we are going to look at digital forensics science. As I already told you in the previous video, so digital forensics is like a umbrella term where we have other subtypes like computer forensics, mobile forensics, email forensics, cloud forensics, etc. So let's look at the parent umbrella term, digital forensics. So here is the definition. Digital forensics is the application of analysis techniques to the reliable and unbiased collection, analysis, interpretation, and presentation of digital evidence. So don't worry about all this, the meaning of all these things, collection, analysis, interpretation, and presentation. Later on, we will see a topic called digital forensics life cycle. There you will understand about all these things. For now, just follow. And then the theme of this module 6, computer forensics. This is the definition of computer forensics. So it is the use of analytical and investigative techniques to identify, collect, examine, and preserve evidence or information which is magnetically stored or encoded. So that means the data that is stored on hard disks, CDs, DVDs, and pen drives or flash drives, etc. So those are the definitions. And what is the role of digital forensics? So what do the people do here? So first thing is uncover and document evidence and leads. So that is finding out the required things on the computer storage, either volatile storage or non-volatile storage, and after they find something, they will document that, okay, either electronically or non-electronically. So documenting means writing down, I have searched for so-and-so files, I have found these files, okay, and these files look suspicious, like that, they will write in the document. And after that, confirm the evidence discovered in other ways. So there are different things the forensics people will try. So that is about that. And assist in showing a pattern of events. Okay, like after finding all the required things about the case, I mean the different things that support the case, they will join all those things they find, and which will ultimately lead to the perpetrator. Okay, so that is this assistant showing a pattern of events. That is, first this thing happened, after that this thing happened, like that. Okay, and then connect attack and victim computers. So in cyber crimes, the target is at different place and victim is at another place. So after finding all the required evidence, they will try to connect that an attack is performed by the attacker on victim system. Okay, so reveal an end-to-end path of events leading to a compromise attempt successful or not. This is also related to the previous points. And then extract data that may be hidden, deleted, or otherwise not directly available. So at this, I mean, for this they will use specialized software. One good example for forensic software is Autopsy. It is free. If you want, you can download and try it, Autopsy. So using that, they can do all these things, find hidden files, deleted files, which are not directly available. Okay. And in which cases the forensics people will try to investigate are here. They are listed here. So in which kinds of scenarios or situations or types of cases. So first one is employee abuse through internet. Okay. So someone is harassing an employee in an organization. And another one is data leak or data breach. Like I said before, for example, a hacker compromised the database. So it falls under data leak or data breach. Industrial espionage, like let's say a group of hackers have stole the secrets of your company, like TCS, HCL, Wipro, etc., Google. That comes under industrial espionage. Next one is damage assessment. Okay. After that, criminal fraud and deception cases, criminal cases, and finally copyright violation, that is pirating. Okay. So, using various forensic tools like the one I told you, autopsy. Using those tools, what kind of data they can see is here like this. So using those tools, they can see history files, they can see unallocated space on the disk, they can see the file stack, the file system information, they can see hidden files, and they can see formatted files and file systems on disk, they can see temporary files, and they can see data clusters. So most of these things are not visible to the general user. Okay. So using these digital forensic techniques, what we can do is we can confirm and clarify evidence otherwise discovered and generate investigative leads for follow-up and verification in other ways, and finally provide help to verify an intrusion hypothesis and eliminate incorrect assumptions. Okay, so using the techniques, digital forensic techniques, we can do all these things. So that's it about digital forensic science.